Active directories usually are the heart of businesses. If you're using more than a handful of Windows machines, this is usually where you manage users, user groups, authentications. Should one of the replications to your domain controllers fail, you'll usually be notified within 5 minutes by angry colleagues because they're unable to log into the shop system, send out quotes, get to their emails. To prevent this, you can monitor your AD replications with PRTG. The first step for this, of course, is having up and running PRTG installations. If this is not the case, I recorded a video which you can find down here, where I'll guide you through the process of setting up your PRTG installation. If you already did this, great, we can simply start with monitoring ADs with PRTG. Now that we're done downloading and installing the trial and our auto discovery is done with running, let's start with monitoring our AD replication errors. For this, I'll navigate to devices. And in my device tree, I'll locate my domain controller. I'll choose this one. And then I simply have to press the little blue plus here and say add sensor. Now there's a variety of ways to search for it. I could search by what I'm trying to monitor, target system type, which would be Windows, or which technology be used. Or I can just type AD replication. There it is. Here's some more information on every sensor, just to keep in mind if you're installing other sensors as well. We have a little traffic light down here, which will tell you about the impact and give you some information of how many sensors we recommend per probe. We'll see this sensor is a little more intensive, but no worries, we don't have that many on our probe. So let's just add it to our device. So now you'll see some basic setup settings. You'll see the replication neighbors. If you have more here, you can select them, deselect all, select a specific one. What I'm trying or want to show you as well is the naming context. I'm gonna leave it at default here, but as you can see, there is four other options. You have schema, which will include the information by which objects, classes, and attributes that are used in the AD are defined. You have the domain DNS zones, which includes the information about the domain controllers that are in the domain. You just have the domain, which includes the domain information about computers or users that are replicated to this domain's controller. And then you have the forest DNS zones, which includes information about the domain controllers in the forest. As I said, I'll just leave it by default. An additional setting that I'm also going to leave, but I just want to show you what it does. You can, of course, adjust the scanning wall interval individually for the sensor. You can choose either one, but I'm just going to inherit it from our parent device. So let's create the sensor. You see it down here now. Now one thing, if you selected more than one replication neighbor, you'll have one sensor for each of the neighbors you selected. As I only had one available, I could only select one. That's why I only see one sensor here. If we jump to the sensor, we currently see that there is no data yet. So let's start querying it. And there we go. This is how easy it is to add a sensor to check for your replication errors. And you'll see it has a bunch of channels. It will give you the last successful sync. It will say, is this deleted source? And of course, you can also view this in the live data graph or in historic data graphs. Did I get you hooked on PRTG yet? PRTG is, of course, your all-in-one monitoring solution. If you have any questions, feel free to contact us at support@pesler.com. Or if there's any other topic you want us to make a video about, please drop us a comment below. And of course, download your trial now.